This is a presentation of a new automatic functionality specially designed to cover the pre-processing requirements for parts with variable thickness or material, so-called tailored blanks, tailored rolled, and others. The Tailored Blank Wizard provides all functionality needed to apply zones with different sheet thickness on a part. The function works on meshed geometry as well as on FE shell elements and creates a new ANSA item called Tailored Blank. The Tailored Blank entity is saved in an ANSA database and can be reused to apply the defined zone patterns on another similar part. Re-editing of the Tailored Blank is also possible in a later phase. Additionally, ANSA parameters can be automatically created and used for an optimization process. Now let's see how to use this new wizard on an example of a B-pillar. Note that this model consists out of pure FE shell elements, which reference three different properties: for the flanges, for the zones around openings, and the rest of the body. The goal is to easily create a certain zone pattern along a trajectory, in this case, along the part's height. Additionally, the initial PID segmentation for the flanges, the zones, and the rest of the pillar should be maintained. The procedure starts by activating the Tailored Blank button in the Auxiliaries drop-down in the Shell Mesh menu. The Tailored Blank wizard starts with the area selection. All elements or geometry of the part to be processed must be selected. Use Ctrl+A to select all visible area after the part has been properly isolated. In the next step, the user has to define the direction. This can be done by using an axis of the global coordinate system or a trajectory, by either selecting curves, perimeters, or node sequences. Next, the user is asked to define the origin of the Tailored Blank definition. It is possible to directly select the lower or upper limit of the part, or to set a user-defined position by selecting a node of the part which will be projected on the trajectory. The procedure continues with the definition of the regions and their zones. Notice the origin, the negative and positive direction of the Tailored Blank item, and the correspondent areas for the region and zones definition. The mirror positive direction option will be used in this example to define the regions and the zones in a symmetrical manner. Defining the regions begins by setting the width, the number of zones, and the thickness. The first region has a width of 200 mm, consisting one zone with a constant thickness of 1.9 mm. The second region also has a width of 200 mm, but will be represented by five zones of variable thickness between 1.9 and 1.6 mm. Finally, the last region's width is set to infinite, meaning that this region goes up to the end of the part, represented by one zone of constant thickness of 1.6 mm. Now we activate the mirror positive direction flag in order to finalize the definition of the whole part and to get a symmetrical thickness distribution along the part's length. In the last step of the tailored blank definition, the user has to decide if nodal or PID thickness will be assigned to the defined zones. Start ID, name prefixes, as well as ID offset for the regions and their zones can be defined. The initial PID segmentation of the flanges and zones of the part can be maintained by activating the Respect PIDs flag, which enables an additional ID offset option. Create or View PIDs offers a preview of all properties which will be created. The user has control over if the mesh will be cut or not to apply the zone pattern and optionally define the area of reconstruction. Finally, an option to directly apply the tailored blank definition is provided. If the definition is not applied in this step, it can be done later on from the tailored blank database browsers list. After definition, design variables can be automatically defined. Task Manager item is also created automatically.